Hello and welcome to the second video in this beginner's guide to Adobe After Effects. In this tutorial, we are going to kick things off from the very start. In this video, we are going to take a look at the Adobe After Effects interface. Now, the first version of After Effects was released in 1995. With all the innovations and new features that have been introduced over the years, up until now, the interface itself has not changed all that much. For those of you that are completely new to After Effects, in this video, I'm going to show you around and introduce you to some of the key things you need to be aware of when starting out. So let's get into it. Now, I'm currently using Adobe After Effects CC 2018 for Mac. If you're using an earlier version or you're on Windows, some things may be a little different in parts, but in principle, it should be the same. So if you have After Effects open and wish to follow along, you will need to first come up to Window, scroll down to Workspace, and then select All Panels. This is to make sure we all have the same setup. Next, we must again go to Window, Workspace, and then scroll down and select Reset All Panels. This will then set the interface to the All Panels default layout, and you should have something that looks like this. What you should have is the default settings, where you can see all the key panels. Now, don't worry if your setup is not exactly the same as mine. On versions of After Effects before 2017, the panels on the far right here may just come all the way down the side of the screen, instead of on top of this panel here. For now, don't worry too much about this. Just follow along and you should be fine. I'll be talking through all of this shortly. So this is Adobe CC, and with CS6 and CC, we have this dark interface. If you're using an earlier version, you may be looking at the light interface. Now, if for whatever reason you wish to toggle the interface color, you can come to After Effects on the top toolbar for Mac. For PC, this is in Edit. Scroll down to Preferences and select Appearance. Upon click, the preference menu will appear. And if we look down here on Brightness, it's here you can toggle the lightness and darkness by clicking and dragging the switch. I like it dark, so I'm going to select the darkest option and click OK. So to begin, I'm going to open up a document. This document is going to help me demonstrate various functionality of the program, which we are going to be covering a little later on in this video. So be sure to open this and follow along. This document can be found in the Introduction folder in the Project folder. Now you can download this project folder for a small fee. The download link with instructions are in the description. The download folder comes with lots of exercise documents we will be using on this course that have been carefully developed to aid your learning experience. The folder also comes with document resources such as videos, graphics, and images you can use to build your first video presentation from scratch later on in this course. To get the full learning experience, I recommend you get the project folder. Download link with instructions is in the description. So with the project folder open, click into the S1 Introductions folder, into the first folder, Interface Introduction, and open the folder of the version you are using and open the Interface Introduction file. And you should have something that looks like this. Now, just a quick thing to mention here. This document contains a particular font. When you open this file, you may get an error message saying you don't have the font installed. To follow along with this tutorial, you are also going to need to install the font first. Now, this is not included in the project folder, as I cannot supply it with the download. Now, the font we are using here is Lemon Milk and can be downloaded for free online. If you come into the project folder, into the project assets folder, click into the typeface folder, you will see a text document here. And if you open this up, it will tell you exactly where to get the font from online. Simply click on the link in the text document and it will take you to the site where you can download it. Once downloaded, be sure to install it. Close down After Effects, then reopen the file and you should be able to follow along just fine. So once you have downloaded the font and installed it, let's continue. Okay, so let's take a closer look at the interface. Now, all of this may look a little complex right now, but don't worry, it's fairly straightforward. At this point, it will help to break the interface down into 5 key sections. 1, the composition panel here in the center. 2, the timeline panel at the bottom. 3, the project panel over here on the left side of the screen. 4, the tools panel on the top of the screen. And 5, a variety of work panels here on the right. So the first thing I want to draw your attention to is the timeline panel. This is the long panel that runs along the bottom of the screen here. This is one of the main panels in After Effects, and it's this panel where we manage our project elements over time. So the first thing to point out here is the timeline across the top of the panel. This represents the length of time of this composition. Below this, we can see the layers that make up the particular composition, each one representing a particular element in the video presentation. In the timeline panel, layers are displayed as bars from left to right that indicate their presence along the timeline, in a particular order and in a particular hierarchy. Now, if I click and drag on the scroll bar over on the far right, up and down, we can see that there are quite a few layers making up this composition, stacked up on top of each other. Now, if you look above the timeline panel, you can see the visual layout of the elements in the composition panel. Now, if you click on the layer bar in the timeline panel, you will see the visual elements selected in the composition panel above, with a bounding box around it. These are the layer controls. Now, if for whatever reason you cannot see the bounding box, come up to View and make sure Show Layer Controls is ticked. This panel here is where layouts are edited visually, which we will be looking into later. So back into the timeline panel, over on the left side of the panel, we can see the names of the layers with icons that indicate which type of media they are. And to the left and right of these are a bunch of switches and modes that can be applied to the layers. So at the bottom of the panel, just under the layer bars, you will see a zoom indicator. We can use this to zoom in and out of the layers on the timeline, and use this to fine-tune applied effects. Notice, as you zoom in, the bar on the right gets smaller. This is used to click and drag through the timeline when zoomed in, and I'll just zoom back out. So lastly, to the left of this, in the far left corner, and just next to the zoom toggle, are some buttons that can toggle the view of some switches and modes that can be applied to the layers above. And if I click these, we can see them appearing next to the layer names. For now, I'll just toggle these off. Now there is lots more to learn about this timeline panel, which I'll be going into in more detail in the next video, but for now, let's move on. So the next panel I want to draw your attention to is the composition panel. This is the big panel in the center of the interface, and this gives us a visual preview of the project we are working on. Now if you carefully move your mouse cursor over an object, you will see a box appear around it. Now if you click on the element in the composition, you will see the bounding box appear around it, allowing us to transform the object or move the element around. Notice, as you click the various elements in the preview, you will see the layer appear highlighted in the timeline panel and its position in the layer hierarchy. Now, it may help to think of this preview area like the canvas area in Photoshop. It's here where we manage the composition of the visual elements over time as we see them on screen. Now, if we look carefully at the bottom of the composition panel, we can see a number of buttons and switches regarding the preview panel above. Now, we will be going over these in a bit more detail as we use them later on in the course, but the key tools to know about initially are the magnification, grid and guide options, preview time, and the resolution display. Now the magnification ratio allows us to zoom in and out of the visual composition to a variety of percentages within the composition panel to get closer to some of the elements and to fine tune animations. If I click 100%, the canvas area will zoom in 100%. If I click the fit option, this will fit the composition screen nicely to the panel. To the right of this, we have the grid and guide options. By clicking this, you will be able to activate a series of grids and guides, such as the title action safe area, proportional grid, and activate the grid, guides, and rulers. Once active, you will have to click these again to turn them off. To the right of this, we have the preview time. This is an indication where the time indicator is located on the timeline. Next, to the right of this, we have the resolution factor. Right now, this is set to full, though if I click this and hit quarter, you will see the composition in the preview panel become pixelated. This is quarter the resolution than full. Here we can also choose half, where we can see it becomes less pixelated. This tool is used to downscale the resolution of the visual elements in the canvas area. When creating projects, we will regularly use this feature as we live preview projects. This is for performance and workflow streamline purposes. Sometimes it can be clunky and slow previewing video and animations. If we set the resolution to low, it previews faster. Now, I'll be demonstrating how this works in the next video. For now, I'll pop this back to full. Now, on occasions, you may find yourself accidentally double-clicking on a layer in your timeline. For example, I'll drag the time indicator to around 2 seconds on my timeline, and in the composition panel, we can see a background blue color. Now, if we scroll down to the bottom of the timeline panel, we can see a deep blue solid layer. Now, if we come and double-click on this layer, upon double-click, the solid layer will appear in another tab at the top of the composition panel. Now, this is a way to isolate a layer to inspect it. Now, in this instance, as you scroll across the timeline, you will not be able to see any of your layers in the composition panel above. Now, as a beginner, you may wonder where your composition has gone. Now, don't worry, if you look carefully in the composition tab at the top, you will see your comp is still present, but on a separate tab on the left. If you ever find you have accidentally double-clicked a layer and you can no longer see your comp, remember you can simply close down the tab in the composition panel at the top or click back on your main comp on the left to come back to your main comp. Remember to keep this in mind, as you may find yourself lost like this at the start. So the next panel I want to draw your attention to is the project panel. This is the panel that is typically placed on the left-hand side of the interface, and this panel contains all the elements that make up our video project. When we bring footage, images, and audio files, for example, into our project, this is where they will be placed. Now, a project may include hundreds of individual elements. This panel allows you to carefully organize your elements into folders, like you see here. If I click and expand these, we can see the contents. If you click down on the folders here, you can see how the elements have been arranged and what it contains. So the next panel I want to draw your attention to is the Tools panel. In After Effects, this panel runs across the top of the interface and contains all the tools that can be used. As you can see, we have lots of icons. To activate a tool, we simply click it or press one of the many shortcut buttons on the keyboard. We know which tool is active because it will be highlighted in blue. In After Effects, we will be using many tools. You will also notice that as we use the tool, the mouse cursor will change, indicating which tool we have activated. Now, if we move to the top of our window, we can see the standard bar across the top, from File, across through to View, Window, and Help. From here, we can access various properties, controls, and initiate some of the creative features in After Effects. But for now, we are not going to go too much into that. So moving over to the far right-hand side, we have a set of panels. These panels are essential in order to produce work and control many variables in an After Effects project, and are kept neatly to the right of the screen interface. And right now, we see these as a stack. Now, in more recent versions of After Effects, to activate them, we can simply click on the name of the panel once to open it. Now, on earlier versions of After Effects, you will need to place your mouse cursor between the panels and click and drag to reveal the contents inside. Now, some of you familiar with other programs like Illustrator and Photoshop will recognize some of these panels. Here we have the Align panel for aligning objects in the Composition panel, and the Character and Paragraph panel for editing type. Now, one of the panels you will become familiar with later in the course is the Effects and Presets panel. This panel includes a lot of visual effect and preset animations we can apply to our layer elements in the timeline panel, and I will be demonstrating this later on in the course. So right now, we are looking at all the panels. In After Effects, you can change the workspace to tweak the panels you see here. For example, if I come up to Window and scroll across to Workspace, we can see a few options here. Here we have Animation through to Text. By selecting any of these, we can change the interface and the panels we see. If we click on Standard, for example, we will see that some of the panels will now disappear. By clicking on the variety of workspaces, we can customize the panels we see. Now, on Standard, if you want to reveal some of the panels that are not currently shown, we can come up to Window, and here we will see the ultimate list of panels we can use, a lot of which are currently not active. To activate one, simply click on it, for example's character. Upon click, it will appear in the panel stack on the right. This also works to remove panels. So back up to Window. This time, if we wanted to take away a panel, simply click one that is currently checked to deactivate it. If we click on character again, it will now take it away from the panel stack. Now, as you activate and deactivate panels and move them around to best suit your needs, you will be able to save your customized workspace. By coming up to Window, scroll across to Workspace, then scroll down to New Workspace, you can name your new workspace, and in this instance, I'll call it GD Workspace, and click OK. Now, if I come to Window and across to Workspace, I will see my new workspace from the list. For now though, I'll come back up to Window, over to Workspace and click on All Panels. For the duration of the course, I will set my workspace to All Panels, as I'll be referencing some of these panels later on in the course. So that's a brief overview of the Adobe After Effects interface. Keep in mind that the software on screen can be broken down into five key sections. 1. The composition panel in the center. 2. The timeline panel at the bottom. 3. The project panel on the left. 4. The tools panel on the top. And 5. The variety of work panels on the far right. So in this video, I give you a brief overview of the interface. Now before we move on, there are some more details you will need to know about some of the panels so you can be ready to create your own project. In the next video, we will be taking a closer look at the timeline panel, learning more about layers, how they work, and how they are managed over time in Adobe After Effects. So see you in the next video.